Okay, so this is the third part of course 6A on longitudinal model of networks. We will see some simple models, independent arc models and reciprocity model, and some variation, especially actor-oriented models, which is a little bit more complicated, but quite precise model of network evolution. So, the simplest model is the independent arcs model. It assumes a total independence of every possible link in the network. So, each link xij at date t follows independent Markov process of outcome chi to states 0 and 1. So, for each link, it can be in state 0, no link, or in state 1, a link exists. We define lambda 0 to be the rate of change from 0 to 1, so the rate of, let's say, apparition of links, and the rate lambda 1 to be the rate of disparition of links from state 1 to 0. So the two states change into each other at rate lambda 0 and lambda 1. The transition rate matrix capital Q can be defined as this expression. And in this very simple case, a lot of complicated calculation allows us to find the stationary distribution, which is this variable. So depending on the values of lambda 0 and lambda 1, you can foresee, you can predict the density of the network according to the values of lambda 0 and lambda 1. And you can also know in what state will be the network after an infinite amount of time. A little bit more complicated model, but still very simple, is the Markov chain for dyads. So every dyad, a couple of nodes, are supposed independent with the same transition distribution, but inside a dyad, so for a couple of nodes I and j, the arc between I and j and the arc between j and I, so I and j and j and I, are dependent. And the outcome space is a little bit more complicated. You have four different states. 0, 0, there is no links neither from I to J nor from J to I. 0, 1, so only one link in one direction. 1, 0, the link in the other direction. And 1, 1, two links, one from I to J, the other from J to Y to I. This led us to define two more transition rates. So the first one to consider is the transition rate that make the reciprocity complete, so that add the link that was missing. So from the state 1,0 or 0,1, if you add the missing link, you arrive in state 1,1, and you have reciprocity between the two nodes. The two other rates are the second rate, sorry, is lambda 1 plus mu 1, which is the destroying of reciprocate links, because you were in the state 1 1 and you arrive in state 1 0 or 0 1. So you destroy the link and you have no more reciprocity. The rate lambda 0 is the same rate as in the independent arc model, so it's the rate of creation of a link between from I to J. So starting from the state 0, 0, it can create 1, 0 or 0, 1. And the final rate is lambda 1, which is the destruction of a single link from I to J or J to I. As you can see, these four rates can lead to very different network configuration. If you make a very high rate that complete reciprocity, so a very high value of mu 0, for example, and a reasonably high value of lambda 0, you will have a lot of chance to make some links appear and be and being completed by the reciprocal link. You can also have some model where the reciprocity is destroyed by taking lambda 1 plus mu 1 to be I, so there is a lot of destruction of reciprocity. And if you take lambda 1 to be I, there is a lot of link destruction, so you can, let's say, remove a lot of arcs, a lot of links in your network. So you see that depending on the values of lambda 1, lambda 0, lambda 1 plus mu 1, lambda 0 plus mu 0, you have a lot of different processes that will change the shape of your network. So knowing the values of lambda 0, lambda 1, etc. in the matrix capital Q is the real network evolution model, because these values will decide what will be the shape of the future observation of your networks. So in fact, when we are looking for network evolution model, we are looking for these kind of values, these values that are inside the transition rate matrix. Okay, so these were simple models, really simple model, but it helps us to understand how the Markov chain can model the evolution of some networks. So we know that even if it's simple, the transition probability equation are difficult to calculate. The hypothesis under which all links and dyads are independent is really too strong. We know that we are in a network and everything is related in a network, so supposing independence of arcs is really, really cheap. But as usual, more satisfying models imply more complex effects than just reciprocity or so on. And it will be impossible to calculate by hand. So when it's impossible to calculate by hand, we make some simulations and we try to make some approximation of the real distribution by making a lot of simulation until we get close to the expected transition rate matrix capital Q. So we will use simulation to approach probabilities distribution. And we will use for that a class of techniques called MCMC for Markov chain Monte Carlo estimation. So, I will stop here, and in the next part I will try to develop the idea of simulation to approach probabilities distribution. Thank you.